Hi, it's Miles Red Songbird, Michelle Birdsong in New York City. Doing this video, it's a funeral of Edwin Birdsong in pictures. Sorry to say, Sing Birdsong was in a car accident last night. The computers he had with him were all smashed up. That's Sing Birdsong. And Sing texted Rob and his sister that he's shaken, but he thinks he's all right. Some of us know that prayer is good because it strengthens the will. Muslims pray 5 times a day. That's why their will to dominate the world is so strong. They're determined. We hardly pray in this country, and many of us don't even have the will to survive, for our values and traditions to survive. People from places like Somalia are coming here replacing the Americans. Watch 1400-year-old secret by scientist Bill Warner, why we're afraid of Muslims. Strengthening our wills regarding Singh's accident won't help Singh, but his godmother Shatima tells me sending Singh unconditional love will help him. It's easy and free. All you have to do is picture Singh wrapped in a blanket the color of unconditional love, pink. All of you who care about Singh, please do this. Singh's friends, Dave Boiler, who was a drummer in a group that included Singh, who was Jimi Hendrix on guitar, and Dave Seller on bass. Jeremy Edelman, a trumpet player, I think Jeremy's a Cancer in astrology. He's a very successful jingle writer. He's done work with Nike. He came to the funeral. And when Edwin had a stroke earlier, Singh came to California from New York. Jeremy let Singh sleep in his studio, and this really impressed Robin. Jeremy let Singh drive his car. And Nick Tester was there. I think he's a doctor now. These are boys who went to school with Singh. Also came to Singh's dad's funeral. They all gave Singh's little sister big hugs. That's Robin. Singh was best man at Jeremy's wedding. These three guys are Singh's friends from high school, Friends Seminary, Gramercy Park, Manhattan, New York. They're good men, also with good parents. Singh's father was aptly described by he and Steve's attorney, my husband, in a past life, Johanna Vagoda. He said, Edwin didn't mean any harm. Edwin described himself as a good guy. I would describe him as unique, unpredictable, and awesome. Edwin, who was very smart, said the inequality in the world was of information. My people shall be destroyed for lack of knowledge, says the Bible. That's why I'm mainstreaming clues to the marginalized. Robin said, Singh does create fantastic drum beats. And she says Singh could make a very good living selling his drum beats. Okay. Email from Michael Spear. Great Master Sawan Singh. This is the cover of the program of Edwin's funeral. Email from Michael Spear. Great Master Sawan Singh. My husband, when he was Great Master, and my husband, now that he's Michael John Spear. He wrote, I'm glad you're able to help Robin maintain her balance, note, with meditation and talk and share. I think L.A. is best for those who are established. It is flat, physically easy, and provides no distraction. In New York City, it's just the opposite. Fantastic energy, profound distractions, and fuel to feed the fire in the belly. I hope Sting gets his butt back to New York. R.S. Michael. R.S. means Radhasamy, Lord of the Soul. Notices of Edwin's death were published in the New York Times with a picture of Stevie Wonder and Edwin, also in the BBC and Rolling Stone, as well as other publications. The New York Times had published on their front page a picture of Edwin sitting at a grand, at one time, this was years ago, when the album What It Is first came out. This is the picture I'm talking about. This picture here, Edwin's sitting at a baby grand piano. Before him stood a crowd of over 100,000 people there in Washington, D.C. for the Poor People's Rally, including Mrs. Coretta Scott King and Mrs. Abernathy Gloria Steinem Aries, presidential candidate Eugene McCarthy Aries. Edwin had been invited to sing It Ain't No Fun Being a Welfare Recipient, words by Edwin's wife, Michelle Birdsong, music and vocals by Edwin Birdsong. Can you see it? There he is. You can see it. Okay. Recognition of the fine and dignified services, talking about these funeral services, by Reverend Sheldon Birdsong of Louisiana, Elzada Williams, Linda Williams, Edwin's sisters, Anthony Birdsong, Sing Birdsong, Angela Birdsong, Robin Birdsong, Edwin's children, and other family members organized and carried out a fine and dignified service. Edwin was very pleased. It was a real service with those who really care for him, such as Sheila Fraser and her son Derek McKeith. Sheila told me in 1979, "Michelle, you are guided by God." When I lived with Reverend Sidney's widow, Mrs. Josephine Birdsong, I noticed how respectful now Reverend Sheldon Birdsong was to his mother. It's good he got away from Los Angeles. It's full of snobs or status seekers. I didn't find Edwin's sisters, Elzada and Linda, to be that way, however. They were hardworking, loyal to family, good people. I just want to say again what an excellent job the Birdsongs did cooperating with one another to do right by Edwin's memory. Robin tells me Edwin died in his sleep on Anthony's couch. He had lost his will to live and his body, any longer. It was the same with Charan Singh. He said his body was not fit for Seva any longer, not able to do volunteer work. He removed the film from his camera. Then, soon afterwards, he had a heart attack, I think it was, and left what he decided was his useless body to be cremated. Cremated. Charan Singh's mate. Charan Singh was Jesus Christ. His mate is Mary. He is now pregnant. He is now in Mary's womb. Going to be her son, if all goes well. Siri Ma, energy daughter of the sun. Mary is the daughter of the sun. Yes, Charan Singh chose to get in the energy of my womb. Womb of mild red birdsong, Michelle Birdsong. When the father pumped me with his supreme beam decoded, be Eve and Ma, mother of the earth, new mother of Charan Singh. Evangeline Adams, successful astrologer. These are my identities, some of my identities. Evangeline Adams used Babylonian or Indian methods of astrology, divine science. That's astrology, Babylonian and Indian astrology, about our children. Sing and Robin. Edwin told me to teach them to think logically. He said think, I added the logically part. I created with the guidance of my son Giancarlo Arturo Charan Singh, Jesus Christ, first and 20th century talk and share, this form of therapy. I was Freud and Pearls and Jung's wife. Jordan Peterson was Jung. This form of asking questions therapy removes the emotions and feelings and negative decisions that block clear thinking. Edwin had told me I should write a book telling people what I did to raise Singh and Robin and Melanie. He obviously thought they were high-level, quality children. Robin won't even use Starbucks Wi-Fi. She knows they are in business. She says it's not right to use their Wi-Fi without spending money in there. I told her I buy coffee if I have the money. I give them free publicity in my videos. I don't want to steal Wi-Fi either. Around the first of the month when my Social Security pension check comes, I buy a sandwich from them. Talk and share. See? The at talk and share. For $10, that's a sandwich I buy from Starbucks. Edwin, you're looking at a picture of Edwin Birdsong, said to me when we were married, if I was a girl, I'd want to be you. If you were a boy, you'd want to be me. He told me 10 minutes after studying me from a ways away. Then he came over to me and whispered in my ear, I'm going to marry you. I said, marry you? I wouldn't even go out with you. Then I made him and his friends, Roy Ayers and Artist Max, show me some ID, their driver's license. We were in Central Park Mall for Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s mourning rally. Edwin died on Martin Luther King's Day of this year. Martin Luther King Jr. is my grandson, has been reborn as my grandson, Lou Ranzinger. Then on Edwin's song, Rising Sign, on the Supernatural album, I heard it one day. I said to myself, what did he just say? He sang, told you so, make your mind, told you so, be a rising sign, feel the future, gonna be your rising sign, and make you hotter than the summer sunshine. Oh my God, he's talking to me, I said. I said I wouldn't go out with him, and now he's got me to fall in love with him. Michael Bublé, Adam, the first ape. I'm Eve. Lionel Richie, President James Madison, talks to me. Dolly Payne, Todd Madison. His wife, that's Lionel Richie's wife when he was James Madison. And Lionel Richie sings Lady, and he sings Truly to his wife. Son's daughter, She Rising. Edwin told me, that's by the time I get to Phoenix, she'll be rising. Edwin told Glenn Campbell, the Rhinestone Cowboy. Edwin told me after the after he transitions to rise, to take credit for the good things I've done for the people I've helped. If I am recognized and credited properly, he'll be off the hook for depriving me of recognition and money when he was alive. That's a What It Is album. He never mentioned me in interviews. People never heard of me. Once he's off the hook, all he has to do is wait for Robin to marry and consummate the ceremony. Edwin and I had our wedding night lovemaking session in Willie Chambers' bed in the home of the Chambers Brothers, 1960. Four-part harmony rock group. Their biggest hit, Time Has Come Today. Willie made it very clear that he wouldn't allow anyone else, any other couple, to sleep in his bed. We had gotten married in their recording studio. Okay, recording studio. G for Gorinda, S for Singh. Gorinda Singh is Jesus Christ, towards first century, and he's been in many recording studios because he was a lot of famous artists. Okay, studio. Saint, you daughter of sun, I open. Operation. So after we got married, they took us to their gig at St. John University in Queens. My son, same name as Edwin's son, Anthony Williams, was St. John the Baptist. This is my oldest son. I was raised at 212 St. John Street. My dad pastored St. John Baptist Church. Okay? When we went on stage after our wedding, still in our wedding clothes, I was wearing a beautiful white trimmed in sparkles gown, which Edwin had picked out for me and bought it at a boutique in Kips Bay. He was wearing a red robe, and I had insisted he remove the braids for the wedding and let his hair be natural. 10 minutes after we saw each other for the first time, he told me he was going to marry me. 20 minutes after we met, he told me he was going to eat me. A week later, he took me and my niece, Vanita Long, to Central Park to pose with Herbie Mann, Artisan Eleanor, and Cindy for Roy Ayers' first solo album. Edwin had encouraged Roy to go solo. His album was called Stone Soul Picnic. A week later, I said that. To pose with Herbie Mann, right? Rush Limbaugh was Horace Mann, the educator. Then Edwin wrote and sang me the sweetest song. He called, I Love You, Michelle, Yeah, Baby. This guy pulled out all stops to make me fall in love with him. One night, Edwin wanted to see me. I told him my boyfriend was visiting. This is during courtship. Next thing I know, my boyfriend, Dr. Donald Bing, and I had been drinking. I stopped drinking in 1968 when I moved in with Edwin. Edwin came over that night and stayed until Don finally just left. He had a gun. He carries a gun. He's a doctor, but he carries a gun, a dentist. He carries a gun. But he's not quick-tempered, so he didn't confront Edwin about invading our date. So Edwin waited him out. Edwin was married before me. He was married to a hairstylist. He shipped out to Germany 3 days after they married. She promised to join him. She didn't. She stayed comfortable in the States and collected her check. After Edwin was honorably discharged from the Army, he came to New York. That's the Army. This is the Army. That's Edwin wearing the shades. Okay. So, after Edwin was discharged, he came to New York and enrolled in Juilliard, studying composition on the GI Bill. He was a student when I met him, and I was an American Airlines stewardess based in New York. They started calling stewardesses flight attendants when they started hiring men to be stewardesses. In 1979, when I was living in Tennessee with singing Robin, and Edwin was managing Roy Air, sending me money here and there. But Mama's living boyfriend, Claude Marshall, who I call Papa, as did his children, William, Nadine, Viola, and Beau, and his grandchildren, Paula, Marshall, Lewis, and Tiny May. Papa worked at the foundry, I think melting steel. He was a tall, good-looking, dark-skinned Capricorn, strong. I had made friends with the Marshall family when I was a tween. I brought him over to our house to meet my mother, Frog, Jindara Ranzinger, a Scorpio then, when she was my mother, and a Scorpio now. She's my granddaughter. Papa started cleaning the snow off of Mama's car window, and the next thing I knew, happy was I that Papa had moved into our house. They were very compatible, Mama and Papa. Mamas and the Papas, huh? They were together till he died. He had started going to church again. But he died running from death angel through the house. Okay, that's a part one of Edwin Birdsong funeral and pictures and words and pictures. I'll do part two soon.